We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Detective Comics 1004. This is the fourth part of the medieval storyline. And this issue is written by Peter J. Tomasi. Brad Walker did the pencils. Andrew Hennessy, inker. Nathan Fairbairn did the colors. Rob Leigh, letterer. Walker, Hennessy, and Fairbairn did the cover. The cover's actually pretty cool. Doesn't really apply to what's going on, but it's still a cool cover and probably would have got me to bought it if I wasn't buying it already. Dave Wildgoes was the assistant editor. Molly Mahan, editor. Jamie S. Rich, group editor. We have learned who the Arkham Knight is. It's a woman named Astrid, and we get her origin story here and how her parents worked at Arkham Asylum. She was conceived there. She was born. Her mother was killed by a batarang thrown by a criminal, but she doesn't know that it was a criminal that killed her mother. She just knows it's a batarang, so she blames Batman. And she grew up in the asylum, secreted away, where no one knew she existed, and she effectively became a sort of anti-Batman. So by being the Arkham Knight, she has assembled a gang of criminals, and she has some nefarious plans. We get to see a brief appearance by Arcane and Dr. Phosphorus, which is pretty cool. And we are left with a lead into next issue, which is going to be the finale of the story arc. This was a solid issue all around. Unfortunately, it is mostly middle story, and it'll probably be a little boring if you just pick this one up by itself. But you combine this with the other issues, and it's a great installment because it fills in a lot of backstory. Unfortunately, not a lot of action. There is some, but the story is pretty dark. It's pretty disturbing about a kid growing up in a mental institution. There is actually a funny joke by Damian in here, which shocked me to no end because I actually giggled at that. But overall, solid issue, great installment, but not a good standalone. That being said, I will recommend it, but only if you're going to read the entire story arc and not this one by itself, because even with the issue before this, not going to make a lot of sense. So worth checking out, and definitely worth a couple of bucks. I don't think I felt ripped off for the cover price. Most likely you could find this for less than cover price. It's not going to be a major storyline, or get it in trade paperback. Solid recommendation, only if you're going to read the entire story arc. It's only a 5-part story, but pretty good so far. But that's just my take. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.